There we go. Hello, welcome to our band concert. My name is Brianna Ortega and I am a senior here. So this evening we're going to have a couple seniors throughout just talk a little bit about their passion for music and why they're in the program. So music has been in my life since day one. I've always loved to sing and dance and listen to music. While I focus more on singing, I wouldn't be the musician I am today without band. This has been my family for 4 years. No matter what skill level you are, you have a place. Mr. G's doors have always been open and welcoming. Whether it was to laugh, gossip, cry, or anything you've been screamed, most of my fondest memories have come from band. It's taught me leadership, how to work as a team, and grit. The things I've learned from Mr. G and band will carry on throughout my entire life, and I couldn't be more grateful for him and the program. Mr. G, thank you for instilling a greater passion for music in me and always encouraging myself and others to be the best version of themselves. You've given everything to this program, and I thank you for that. Enjoy the concert!
Thank you. surviving the monsoon out there tonight. It's so great to see you all and to be in front of a live audience for the first time all year. So I think that's worth applause right there itself. Say what they want to say, and I'm not sure what they're going to say, but they're going to do that for a little bit. But I want to tell you all, if you're a parent of any student that's in this concert band, which is almost all freshmen, it's been fun to see the growth take place. From the first week where we kind of started together in the basics, and we're playing some intricate rhythms and harmonies and textures and forms, and they've really done me real proud, and you should be proud of them too. So I'd like to give the concert band one more big round of applause for their work for them. So we have one piece that's going to take you to a distant land. It's a very interesting piece in terms of harmony and rhythm and multimeter. It's a piece called Fable, and then we'll bring up our symphonic band in just a moment.
Thank you. essentially, from my 4 years of high school, I've been in bands and I've made countless friends and I've made lasting memories of the best of lifetime. A lot of my favorite experiences and memories from band essentially stem from a lot of our late night jazz sessions and the orchestra as well. While both of those are slightly different from each other, the smaller nature of the group, it really had us get to know Mr. Green one-on-one. I know it's sad that we won't be here next year, but it's also important to remember the decades-long fights that we've been making. With that, Mr. G, I'd like to say thank you very much for all you've done. You've given this all for every single student, and we'll greatly appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you. a senior in the band program, and I still remember my first day in band camp, coming in, and there were all these big kids. There was all this, like, I was honestly scared to go there. I was shy, and there just seemed to be so much culture, like deep-rooted culture, and whether good or bad, in the band community. And as the year went on, I just, with pep band, just becoming part of the family of the band program was amazing. And my biggest regret is just this year I joined jazz band, another part of the band program, which has a completely different feel than the pep bands. It's really small groups, especially jazz one, it's really like intimate and fun. And every time I think about it, it just seems like such a big program, but then I remember that Mr. G's in the, like, he's in the center of all of the different facets. He's not just a teacher. He's the band program. And I can't wait to see what happens next year. I'm really excited for some new growth in the band. And I'm really excited to see where Mr. G goes on. I'm truly grateful for you, Mr. G. And yeah, just thank you.
My first year here, we played this piece that we're about to play with our wind ensemble that you're going to hear. It'll take you to a distant land for those of you who've had the privilege of traveling. I've never been there, but it's on the bucket list, but we're going to play some really fun Irish music. And this is fun because the percussion is really good to do a lot of explorations, a lot of polyrhythmic ideas, meaning many things happening at the same time, a lot of technique, a lot of great solos. We hope you enjoy it. Ireland, legend and lore.
Thank you.
but I could tell I was getting better as I went along. And finally, I joined high school band. And Mr. G was talking about all these things, like the circle of fourth and the chromatic scale, and I had no clue what that was. But I quickly learned, and I would have never imagined that I would work my way all the way up to an ensemble. I like to say I cheated my way in, because they had no saxophones and they had no oboes at the time. So I was like, hey, Mr. G, I can play both. I definitely felt myself improving in one ensemble, and it challenged me in ways that Symphonic Band never would. So I have to thank Mr. G for believing in me and for being the best band director I've ever had. So, thank you.
Holst suites. This is the second one. It was written in 1922. So think about that. Next year, this piece is 100 years old, and it still sounds modern. It's exciting. The kids love it. They don't necessarily need high, fast, and loud all the time. We do a little of that. But this is based on beauty of phrasing and harmony and melody and rhythm. So we hope you enjoy it. This is the same person who wrote The Planets, if you're familiar with that piece. So the Gustav Holst suite, we're going to start in an odd order. We're going to start with the third movement, Song of the Blacksmith. So picture that hot, maybe turn of the century, where we're pounding away at the anvil, and we're working on something, maybe some horseshoes. And so this first movement, you'll picture that, and then we're going to play a march, and it's going to take you all over the place. So we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
As the percussion section, they're the hardest working crew in the band. They always are. They always have about 50 instruments to cover on any given tune, a lot of techniques, and they don't have the luxury of these mortals to be able to sit in a chair and just stay there. So they have to keep track of everything at all times, and they do a great job. And they are led by our fearless percussion instructor. We're going to talk a little bit more, like I said, later, but Mr. Herky is not learning his GED right now. He's going to sit in and help us out on a part that we don't have covered. So let's thank Mr. Herky right now for that. I would also like to give a big thank you. We are privileged to have a number of alumni that are in the audience tonight, which is great. And we also, I see you too, Ryan. I also am very glad that students come back and they want to give back to the program. So we have some students that are back all the way from Boston and from Minnesota and from Whitewater. And let's see, where else do we have students back from right now? I think that's about it right now. But so I would like to thank Kyle, who's sitting in with us right now on the alto saxophone. Still very active playing in Boston. And then let's see, we have Anya over here in front of me on the first floor. She's in Sable from Minnesota and actively playing an instrument. And then over here on the trumpet from UW-Whitewater, actively playing. And all these people are in different careers in music, but still making a lot of music. Mikey Joyce on the trumpet. A student sitting in tonight, Kiana Amrite, who just wasn't feeling up to it tonight, so we hope that Kiana's feeling better, but she's here with us, and we appreciate it. So I think we're ready for percussion. We're going to play a wonderful piece that has got a lot of multimeter. When I say multimeter, a lot of times music is in common time, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Well, you're going to see 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1. So talk about integration of the other curriculum. We're talking math and history and science and all that stuff here. So this is a piece called Undertow by the great John Mackey, and then we're going to combine forces with all three groups at the end and be led by a student leader we'll tell you about. So we'll get there in a moment. This is Undertow.
Thank you.
12 speakers that came up to me that wanted to talk. I do want to acknowledge this, we do this every year. So, in Symphonic Band, I want Jalen to come on over and join the mix wherever Jalen is right now. Jalen, come on over. So, we're going to be honoring a number of these students coming up here in the next week or some days. We are going to give one award out today. We're going to announce somebody. But for right now, I would like to acknowledge, like some of the students talked about, it starts off when they're freshmen. They come in for a camp, and many of them don't know anybody. And they learn the X's and O's of our band program in that summer. And these students have stuck with us. They've been confronted. They've had so many great choices. Most of these students have said, you know what, even though my GPA could be a little bit higher if I had taken more AP classes, which are wonderful, but a lot of these students decided they stay with band, they don't get that weighted grade. And that means they're competing against other students sometimes, for certain spots in colleges, but that shows their dedication, their love. And not everyone's in that boat, but they just stuck with this program for 4 years because there's something inside them that said they had to be part of this. So at this time, I know that we have denoted in the program, but could I have every single senior in the band, those of you back there percussion, I'm gonna have you hang on for just a second. If there's any seniors, come on up forwards so everyone can recognize you. Seniors, come on up here, and everybody in the band right now who's a senior, please stand and receive a thundering round of applause.
But he's going to continue to play in MSOE next year.
And so he'll be nearby if you need a trombone player to hire. He's one of the people you want to call. So congratulations to Dietrich. Let's get everyone up here with your instruments. Dietrich is going to take the podium and conduct two pieces, and then we're going to do a little something after that. All right? So, songs. This will get a little lively in here, so if you need to, cover your ears. It's gonna get strong.
So BC opened its glorious doors in 1956. And since then, we have only had three band directors at Brookfield Central. We've got Ted Binger, who opened the building, passed the baton on to Al Johnson. And then 25 years ago, Jason Gillette walked into BC with his saxophone, probably wearing a stupid cutout, but you know, his impact is, you know, it's behind me, it's in front of me, it's throughout the country, it's throughout the world, as people he has touched in terms of his special qualities that he has. I've enjoyed getting to know him as a person, talking to him as a father, talking about our kids, talking about our family. And, you know, when I came here to BC 8 years ago, certainly the first time I heard the BC bands play, I knew that Jason had the chops for music. That's pretty apparent. It's apparent tonight as well. But his true impact, I got to see firsthand in a time of sorrow. 5 years ago, BC grad Sergeant Matthew Thompson, class of 2006, was killed in action in Afghanistan. And Jason and I rode to the funeral together, and we sat by each other in the funeral. And during the funeral, which was in a packed church, in a very emotional scene, countless kids, countless families came up to Jason and seeked him out, whether they were recent grads or current students as well. And just like a great coach, you know, a great coach's legacy is not in a trophy case. And if that's a coach's legacy, well, that person's doing it wrong. And certainly Jason, as he's taken his bands throughout the country and throughout the world, and what we hear in spring concerts and winter concerts at bebop, and the list goes on and on, certainly the music that they make is amazing. And certainly Jason has a passion for making amazing music. But that is a distant second to his passion for caring for kids, for leading kids, for helping them become better people. Because really that's what our business is. And I'm sorry that he's leaving. He's had a tremendous impact. I'm gonna miss debating whether woodwinds are even close to being as good as brass. And you know, typically we have good back and forth with that. He's been a tremendous caretaker of the band room. He's been a tremendous caretaker of the kids. And I'm gonna miss him. He's gonna have a kid here next year, so I can still get to see him. But I wish him all the best, because the 25 years that he gave this school have changed it for better. And let's give him a nice hand. So.
Thank you, Mr. Chris Walker. I wasn't prepared for that. I'm gonna be really strong here. I'm gonna try. We've had a couple moments already that snuck up on me when I wasn't expecting them. Those words mean a lot to me. I wanna say some thank yous and some things. I know I'm not gonna get it all tonight, but the good news is that we've got Bebop Under the Stars, June 5th. Where we're expecting 500-600 people possibly to come. I hope you can be there and see these students in action. They'll play a lot of great music, so we can say some more possibly that night if I miss it tonight. So Mr. Ritzmacher, when he came aboard, it's always difficult to have change. But one thing that you learn in life is resilience, and I think that's what I titled the program, something like resilience. typing up the program. And if I did miss anybody's name, you can send me an email. I'm sorry if I missed any more. Miss Bell, that's my fault. I hope I didn't. Mr. Gritzmacher, as a leader, has been more than a boss. He's been a friend, and he's been like a brother. I never had a brother. And there's so many times where he's come to me when I needed him the most. I had a bad spell where all of a sudden something happened. So all of a sudden I was laying in the hospital every other week, it seemed like. You know, it was four lung surgeries and two heart surgeries. And Mr. Gritzmacher would show up at the hospital and he would call me. And he was there for family things. But when we went through that, he's been a dear friend and always will be. So I want to thank you for everything you've done for me personally, professionally, and it'll continue on. A lot of people want to thank. I wish I could name every band parent that has come through the doors and come in and fitted a student for uniforms or volunteered for the chili feed or for concession stands or for bebop. The list goes on. There's trip chaperones, pancake breakfasts. We need an instrument. They're there. Friends of BCHS Bands is like the greatest parent organization on earth. You can't find better parents. You can't find better kids. We'll get to that in a second. But to all the parents that kind of took me under the wing, as I told them, we had a meeting the other night, they were the first group that I officially told. I said, you've kind of been like parents to me as well, not just organizers, but you've given me that advice. When I started as a 23-year-old, and I took a group to Texas when I didn't even know how to tie Velcro shoes. I had no business taking kids, but these parents just took me under the wing and said, no, I wouldn't advise doing that, dude. So I appreciate all of the great parents that we have. To the students behind me, I'm not going to find better people, better kids. I'm not going to find better administrators in this building. I'm not going to find better faculty. They are family. Without getting into a lot of reasons, I'm going to challenge myself in just a different way. I'm going to have to work twice as hard, but that's what this is about. To my students behind me, and the students that I see that are here right now, and I counted something like 4,000 students between all the band students, the kids we worked with in musicals over the year. It's a lot of kids. You've been my teacher more than I've been yours. It's the truth. And Mr. Gritzmacher mentioned Matthew Thompson. I have his picture in my office, and he serves as a reminder of how to live each day, and all the other students that have come through my doorway, just at the door. I know I've crashed and burned a number of times as a teacher. It's probably the things that I've said and done that I regret, but there's one thing I can tell you, that I go to bed every night thinking about how to become better at teaching and connecting. And sometimes I've failed over the years. I hope more often than not, I didn't. So to you, you are my life. I have my family, which I'll talk about, but you're my family. And even though I'm going down the road, I still live here. I'll be a big part of this community, and I'll support everything you do. And when you need letters and recommendations and job calls, I'm on the top of the list, please, okay? I've mentioned this before. We're up to, this will be 60 student weddings this summer. The fact that students feel that this program meant a lot and they trusted me enough to help me be part of that means a lot, and I want that to continue. I want to talk real quick, Mr. Reineke, where are you at? Right over, there you are. Mr. Reineke, we've been together for 25 years, and my first year of teaching here, Mr. Reineke was in the band. And if those kids, Mr. Reineke, weren't as great as they were, the average high school band director is out of the business within 4 to 5 years. Because he was so great along with those other students, I remained here, and he stayed on after graduating from college and giving his entire being to being a great teacher and a mentor and role model. I couldn't have done the things that I've done without you, and I hope that you continue here with whoever comes in after and build that relationship, and we'll continue to do the same. because I really appreciate everything you do. You're a really giving person beyond belief. So let's give it up for Mr. Hurley.
To me, and the friendships that I've made are unmatched. And and I can tell you that I'm going to miss it a lot. And finally, I would like to speak on behalf of everybody here and give a massive thank you to Mr. Gillette for always having his office door open, always pushing us to be the best we can be as musicians and as people, and for always giving 110% to his students. And thank you all for coming out tonight. I hope you enjoyed the concert.
Everyone, of course, my mind is in a lot of places. I have to also thank, they came here to be at these concerts and to be with our family. They're sitting in the front row. My dear mother and father-in-law, Dennis and Phyllis, who moved here from Iowa this June, and talk about two of the greatest people on earth. I'm so blessed to have you here with us and supporting us every step of the way. So my wonderful mother-in-law and father-in-law, Dennis and Phyllis, and then we are all cordially required, because we don't want the custodians to lift one extra finger. We'll get all this stuff out, get to the band room, and then we'll take a big collective breath. Thank you all for being here, and we'll see you on June 5th outside Bebop Under the Stars. And yes, you can get tickets there or online. Check it out. Oh, Ellie's here right now. I forgot that. Ellie's here. Okay. My brain. I had this all worked out. Allie, you're over here. I didn't see you over there. I know I put it in the program, but okay. Thank you, Nikki. All right, so off to my right, Mrs. Hickman, who to me was Allie Shane, when she was a student in the band. Graduated in 2004, just, yeah, 2004. So Mrs. Hickman has become my colleague in the choir department. And she has taken a program that was already highly successful, and she's already built it to a whole other level. But more importantly, she's someone that I go to every single day. I don't think we've had a day this year where we don't talk about life and children and music and our students. And she is like a sister, a family member, a colleague, a best friend, all those things wrapped in one. And if I could take everyone with me, I would. She'd be at the top of that list. There's no way that we won't continue to stay connected, because I love you dearly. So Mrs. Allison Hickman, everybody. Thank you so much for having us. Stay dry. Again, hope to see you at Bebop June 5th. Dan, congratulations. Wonderful work today.